To master something is not easy, it's a process. On this way, there are a lot of challenges, a lot of emotions. There are disappointments when you drop your hand and don't want to do it again. But nonetheless, if the God has laid down this direction and love to this work in someone's soul, I think this person will be able to go through and overcome any difficulties, crises, and any creative falling, and then experience new inspiration to go on doing this work. This story is about a master whose life path is winding like the root system of a huge tree, and whose scope of creativity is wide like its crown. Peter Nikolaevich Nosikov from Russia can be called a painter, a sculptor, a toy maker, as well as a carpenter and a woodworker. All this because he deals with artistic wood carving, and it's so hard to be talented just from one side in this craft. The creative range. Working with wood, I consider it unlimited. There are loads of directions, types of carving, beginning with something primitive as maybe half-dimensional bas relief or toys, and ending with complex sculptural work. And there is also root plastic, when a cutter is used minimally. But mainly everything is stayed natural. You've got a snake, a carver adds just a bit of his creativity to emphasize some details. And as a result, he gets a really beautiful artwork. You know, there is a wide range of creative work with wood. Each material has its own distinctive features, its own character. Well, why do I work particularly with wood, and this is close to me? To my mind, wood always conveys warmth. You know, if you have ever been to interior where everything is designed from wood, first of all, now you are in my workshop and you can smell the presence of wood which these logs produce. Well, it's always good for your mood. And wood also conveys warmth of your mind, character, especially when you carve some animals. So that's why this material always brings some warmth. The story of Peter Nikolaevich will be clear and close to many artists for whom the craft has become something more important than self-expression, just hobby. Because it's the story of them who create beauty for the joy of others and for whom creativity has become profession. It's also the story of everlasting partings of master with the products of his skilled hands and creative soul work. And what's the most interesting, the partings are desirable. I've been doing wood carving for more than 20 years. How many items have been made in the whole is hard to say the number. I can't even imagine it. I can monitor the wear of some items. I know where they are, where people enjoy them. And new clients very often call from these places after having spotted these items. As far as the items, well, I don't know where they are, whose house they belong to. The list of Peter Nikolaevich's works is great and looks more like an avid hunter's trophy collection. All of those heads of deer, mooses, mufflons and boars can be the part of a large exposition as in an art gallery, as in a wildlife museum. However, these items have found their lucky owners living all over the world. All that has been left to their author is a photo collection of his masterpieces, which is kept on his PC hard disk. And that is good because it often happens that only memories of Peter Nikolaevich's work remain to him. As usual, I try to take photos, but it can't be done in every case. Sometimes customers can be so hasty and orders can be so urgent that I have carved the item and don't have any time to take a photo of it. Customers come and take it away, so I have to take photos of some of my works while visiting the places where they have been installed. As every strong tree is a thin sprout at the start of its life, so is every wooden sculpture is born through light lines on a sheet of paper. The author begins working on his masterpiece with a sketch. By the way, Peter Nikolaevich made his first steps on the path of artwork and painting. As a child, he finished an art school. Then he decided not to stop on his achievements and became to develop himself in handicraft. At that time, I used to live in the Caucasus in Grozny city, and the main direction that I wanted to do was the artistic metal processing, such as embossing, jeweler work. I went to Moscow region to enter the Abramsov College, but so it happened that I turned to work with wood at last. I moved to other college, it was the College of Woodcarving, and everything was made from wood at that college. There were sculptures, carved frescoes everywhere, they were all the students' graduation works. When you got there, you had an impression that you were in a fairy tale land, because all those sculptures were fairy tale characters. I was impressed by that very much and understood it was mine. The college in Bogorod, which Peter Nikolaevich finished, can be surely called unique. It keeps the folk handicraft of dimensional wood carving and passes it from generation to generation. Everybody knows Bogorod's bears and the men banging with hammers on an anvil. For more than six centuries, these toys have been bringing joy to children in Russia, and craftsmen of Bogorod are really considered to be the most skilled carvers. No wonder that a young artist Peter Nosikov decided to devote himself to this ancient handicraft. The first work that could be shown was a chicken in a basket. Just a small finger, the chicken sitting in the basket with a scallop and a tail. It was the first item. Next works were of more complicated forms. They were Bogorod's bears, a singing bear, and a bear with an accordion, and so on. Yes, that was the first work. I have left a lot of my first items, but it was 1989, so it's very hard to find it now. But I think it's somewhere here. All the students who were studying always tried to carve something for sale. The reason was that the first sold item caused great inspiration to go on working. Students became very interested, and I also was interested. The first market where we sold our works was in Ismailov Park in Moscow. Then it was Old Arbat, where artists as well as wood carvers got together. The craft of wooden sculpture, which Peter Nikolaevich studied, is considered to be the most difficult type of wood carving. One thing is a two-dimensional sketch on paper, and completely other is to see a dimensional figure inside an ugly stub. Even pencil outlines that cover makes would hardly ever be clear to anybody else except himself. And he's the only one who knows that it is a graceful heron in front of him, and it is left, as great Michelangelo said, to cut off all unnecessary stuff. Lots of customers order these sculptures, I mean herons, because they are so beautiful and look very graceful with their thin legs and thin necks. I have carved so many of them that practically I draw it with a pencil straight on this stub or that log. And then I try to find shape of it with a chainsaw or an electric saw and with chisels. Naturally, at first you carve out what you have drawn with a pencil, and then you look for a shape itself by cutting off unnecessary wood with chisels. The initial rough search of the shape is quite a hatchet job, but instead of an archaic axe, the craftsman takes a chainsaw, one of a few modern tools which Peter Nikolaevich uses in his work. And this despite of the fact that nowadays there are lots of devices that can simplify his task. In our high technological century, there are even programmed machines that can carve dimensional figures from wood faster and more accurately than any other craftsman. But Peter Nikolaevich is not afraid of such competition. I don't compete with them. They are trying to compete with artists, craftsmen who deal with handicrafts. But do you know what's the main difference? When machines make a wooden sculpture, there aren't any of those grooves, smooth transitions where all facets of handicraft can be observed. Mainly these items don't have any character, although they are made of wood, which is warm itself. But you can say they are spiritually dead. You have seen maybe a box of chocolates. There are molds for candies. They're like extruded shapes. And so are these wooden items. They look like something stamped. But when you make something with your hands, not only the technique of carving can convey the mood, but you can convey your soul, your character, yourself. No matter how high technological the machine is, it will never be able to convey all this. I try to keep old handicraft traditions. But to make something big, I sometimes use electric tools, jigsaw or electric planer, to connect something, to cut outlines. But mainly, to make a shape itself, there are just chisels and knife, of course. It's amazing how a rough stub suddenly takes a graceful form of an animal or a bird in carver's hands. Some masterpieces amaze us with their accuracy. For example, only antlers of this American deer are natural, but the head itself is Peter Nikolaevich's work, though it can be noticed just by a very close examination. Having only creative imagination is obviously not enough to make such masterpieces, as I often carve animals. When I walk past some animals, I always stop and look at their character, as well as at plastic anatomy and body proportions, watch their behavior. As for American deer, I watch them very often, how they grazed in the middle, how they came out, how they tried to eat flowers even under the windows. At the time, I was to America not once, also worked there, carved some items and had a chance to watch them. And by the way, I brought more than one pair of the antlers from there. There are lots of them in the forest. You may just walk and pick them up. In Peter Nikolaevich's rock collection, there are such representatives of fauna which he hasn't ever met himself. To recreate perfect images of mysterious black-tailed gazelles, buffaloes or argalis is not an easy task, but for a real sculptor it's quite solvable, even though he's good just flat images as examples. For this work, I use photos, pictures, drawings of some painters who were devoted to it, worked under it, learned this anatomy, where they give more correct image of this peculiar animal using the pencil or paint. I collect such materials, examine a photo or a picture from all sides, from all angles, try to realize it. Some more difficult figures surely are needed to be sculpted from clay at first, to feel their volume myself. And when you begin to feel this volume and understand that you can bring it in the wood, just start working. My aim is not to copy the anatomy. My aim is to give the item its own style. Even at the college, while studying the technique of carving, I saw that Bogorod's handicraft had got its special style. I think when you work with wood, there always must be a special style, to my point of view. It's not necessary to carve an exact copy with all anatomic features. But when you give a special style to the wooden item, it turns to be rather more interesting.
shavings for shavings, chamfers for chamfers, so that the trace of the chisel is called in carving. A wooden workpiece is approaching to become a graceful sculpture. Indeed, the wood carving craft is a hard work, demanding strong hands and sharp tools. However, the work speed also depends on the flexibility of the material. It's clear that to create something from oak is harder than from aspen. In his creative work, Peter Nikolaevich prefers materials tasted by many generations of Bogorodsk masters. Generally, any kind of wood can be used for carving, but I use mostly linden. Firstly, because I got this direction in the college, my hands got used to this material, because when you have been working for many years with the same material, you know not only the texture of it, I mean its softness or its ductility, but you also begin to feel this material with your soul, how to play with it. You can feel all the fibers. I think every carver always uses one main kind of material. However, I've happened to work with oak in parallel. I've happened to work. One day I got an order for a sculpture from such material, you know, buckout. It grows in South Africa, in Mexico. It is also called iron wood. I worked with this wood. At first, I thought it must be very tough, so tough that I couldn't imagine how to work with it. But after I began working, I liked this material very much. It gives such a beautiful tone, glitter on chisel cuts. So it happens to work with different types of wood. But I can repeat my main directions working with linden. A craftsman will be carving two herons for more than one day, even from responsive and soft linden. And again, just photo will be left as a memory of those days. However, Peter Nikolaevich is philosophical to parting with his wooden sculptures. He believes that only by getting new orders and fulfilling new tasks, he can grow and develop himself as a master, as an artist, even if he expresses in the wood others' wishes and ideas of the beauty. All customers can be so different. For one, it is enough just to see some items that are represented on my website, and the customer hasn't got any questions. I make the same item, but of course, when it's handicraft work, the exact copy can't be made. But even if I have such opportunity, I will try copying the item to bring some new ideas to it, which to my mind can represent this work better. There are some customers who offer their own sketches, and I do the work with their sketches. They always give their wishes, what they'd like to see in this item, their corrections. In these cases, I always listen to the customers, try to realize also their wishes and ideas in the woodwork. When I realize just my idea, I try to make it as it presents in my soul to express it. When a customer makes an order, I certainly try to understand his soul, what he wants to see, to realize this in the wood then. But there are a lot of ideas that I try to develop later, which have come particularly from customer sketches. So, on the one hand, I'm developing my creativity in this workshop, but my customers also help me to develop. It turns out that Peter Nikolaevich's works are the result of collective creativity. What's more, creativity is international, since the orders come from different countries. Just recently, the master has created the moose's head for a customer from the USA. Or how hard in any way was this work? I have been making those mousses for quite a long time. This mousse is maybe the 8th or 10th. By the size, it was the largest one of all I have ever carved. Well, only the antlers were about a meter and a half width, and they weighed about 18-20 kilograms. I've carved the head. In fact, I was just carving it. I was looking for the antlers to fit to this head.
Of course, such monumental work is a challenge for the carver, who originally studied handicraft of tiny wooden toys. But here is the interest of the work for customers. Every person who comes to Peter Nikolaevich helps him to open and to perfect new sides of his skill. One man ordered this. He was a dentist by profession, and this moose head was different from all others in the way that he asked to make this moose smile, to make a smile on it, so that when his friends would come around, he could show them that he was a dentist and could make good teeth even to mooses. And many people ask me why it has a Hollywood smile. Those who don't know the story with that it went to America, and everybody has the same smile there, so it should suit too. It happens that Peter Nikolaevich has to learn a new specialization, for example, try himself in carpentry. And though making furniture is not his strong point, he can take in this order too, but with one condition, if in the course of work he will have to deal more with artistic challenges. And I had such order from one woman. He decided to surprise her husband, indeed who is the husband in the family, the head, the king, and she had an idea to make him sit on a throne. I began to work on it. Surely there was some part of a lion in it. This was a coat of arms with two lions with a crown on the top. Also armrests and legs ended with the lion's paws, lion's head at the bottom. When I had finished this work, I delivered it to her house, so the next day she could seat her husband on a decent place of honor. The story of Peter Nikolaevich Nosikov could stay the story of a shoemaker without shoes, if it wasn't the central object in a carver's workshop, the huge wooden fresco, the work on which is far from finishing. But the master doesn't hurry. He devotes himself to this work just in his free time, and if he has any special inspiration, because for Peter Nikolaevich this fresco is absolutely unusual item. I started making this fresco about 4 or 5 years ago, I don't remember exactly. I'm carving it just for my soul. It's not a customer's order, not for sale. The idea came to me, indeed it's not my own idea, it's the idea of 2000 years ago. When the story of the good shepherd and the sheep was told. That's a gospel story, which is written in the Gospel of John. The subject has inspired me very much. I wanted to realize it in wood, as it's also called the Bible story. When I started to draw sketches of oncoming work, when I began to realize it in wood, I suddenly discovered that from one side it was a gospel story, and I saw that this fresco showed also the state of my own soul, because it seems we can see the shepherd and the sheep here, but the main idea that I want to pass is the peace of the human soul, when you can feel safety, calm, peace, satisfaction. And there is not only the state of peace and calm, but as you can see, the sheep don't care, don't worry about anything, they are quiet when the shepherd guards them. Nevertheless, no matter how calm and peaceful the heart is, there is a lot of evil in the world around us. And I've also shown the image of a snake. It is here. It can hardly be seen, but it is here. But when shepherd guards his sheep, they have nothing to fear of. Someday this fresco will be completed and will take its own long-awaited place in the master's house. And maybe it will be the first showpiece of Peter Nikolaevich's works exhibition, where people can come to enjoy his wooden sculptures, not only on the photos but life, as he himself did in the museum of his alma mater, Bogorodsk Woodcarving College, many years ago.
When I entered this college, I met one man whose house was cluttered with the items he had made himself. And I could imagine that I would have the same house, that people would be able to come and watch. But nevertheless, when you make an item and sell it, every time the idea comes to mind that you will carve the next item better and just for yourself. But when you carve the next item, you think the next one will be better again. So I can see my creative work is a process, in that I can't say I has reached some good results. I can modestly say I'm just learning it. So what about some things that I can leave for people to come here and enjoy? I always save my ideas for later to realize them one day.